No, rabbinic law is very specific on that point. If a man's neighbor shall kill his oxen, he must replace the oxen. It's as simple as that.
Rabbi.
Come in, sit down. Okay. Now, okay. Listen, don't take my advice. It's okay. And you can rot in hell. relatives. Well, my son, what can I do for you?
Harry Adelson, Rabbi.
Mr. Edelman, it's a pleasure to meet you.
Adelson,
you Rabbi. Said Edelman.
No, Rabbi, I...
Fine, if you don't want to use your real name, it's okay with me. Have a seat then, Mr. Smith. Sit down right there.
Adelson.
Whatever, tell me then. What's your problem?
Well, it's a little difficult to say, Rabbi. Mm-hmm. I seem to be having some marital difficulties. Mm-hmm. I believe that my wife is unfaithful.
Let me tell you a story. When I was a young man, more than anything else in the world, I wanted a pair of saddle shoes that I saw in the window of a department store in Russia. Every day I prayed for those shoes until Hanukkah came. And then on the eighth day of Hanukkah, guess what happened? War broke out. They invaded the city and burnt all the shoe stores to the ground.
What does that have to do with my marriage?
Nothing. Why should it?
Because we were talking about my marriage.
And I was talking about my shoes.
Rabbi, you do not seem to understand here. My wife is sleeping with another man.
Sleeping? In the bed sleeping?
Yes.
Naked in the bed sleeping?
I'm afraid so, yes.
I see.
So what do you think we should do?
Kill her.
What?
Kill her.
I can't believe that you're saying that.
What? What's so terrible? It's not like I'm telling you to go eat pork on Shabbos. I just said kill her. What's the big deal? Tell me where in the Bible it says thou shalt not kill.
Where in the Bible it says thou shalt not kill?
Show me.
Right here it says in the book of Exodus. It's here. It's thou shalt not kill.
Let me see that book. Thou shalt not kill. What is this, the King Edelman version? Let me find my book. Here's my book. This is my book.
This book is handwritten.
It's the original.
Here, the Ten Commandments.
Nine. See?
One's been crossed out with a black crayon.
It came that way.
Wait a minute. Rabbi, this isn't right.
What?
On the seventh day, God rested from his labors.
Uh-huh.
And then on the eighth day...
Go on.
And on the eighth day, God woke up and said, phew, it was all a dream.
That's it. It's all a dream. So you see, none of this is real. You, me. You're no good whore of a wife. It's just a dream God's having. Wake up! Wake up, you! Doesn't do any good. He dreams, we suffer. For all we know, World War II might have been just something he ate that didn't agree with him.
World War II?
A bad piece of fish.
I cannot accept that.
So convert. Convert, what do I care? What, you're the only man in the world with problems? Look, my son, take my advice, all right. Maybe killing is a little harsh. I'll give you that. You don't like to kill. I don't like to give my car to the valet parking kid because when it comes back, it always smells different. You know what I'm saying to you?
Rabbi, maybe I should come back again.
Mm-hmm. You and the Messiah. You don't like my advice? Take my book and go someplace else. Why don't you go to Kugelman's Bakery and ask an onion roll for advice?
Maybe I should do that.
Fine. No wonder your wife won't sleep with you. Neither would I. Even if you baked me. What a nice man. I wonder if he's Jewish. Wake up!